Hello students, I welcome you all in this video lecture series on chapter CAMS. In today's lecture we will see the introduction of CAM and types of CAMS and follower. So let us start. So the CAM and follower is a device which can convert a rotary motion or a circular motion into linear reciprocating or an oscillatory motion. Now in this animation also you can observe that whenever one rotary part, that is a CAM, is rotating over the shaft, it transmits the motion, rotary motion, into the linear motion of the follower. Now the CAM is rotating machine element which gives the reciprocating or oscillatory motion to the another element known as a follower. Now here you can observe also that when a CAM is rotated about its profile, the follower is making in contact, and that contact is a uniform, the contact is not broken. And that contact can be made exact or precise with the help of spring or a dead weight attached over the follower. In second example also you can observe that whenever a CAM is rotating, the follower is oscillating about its fulcrum point. So any motion, that is linear motion or oscillatory motion, can be given to the follower, whereas CAM is rotating about its own axis, that is about the shaft. So this is in general CAM and follower. This motion can be used in various applications, such as first example is an IC engine where the CAM and follower is used in maximum times. So in IC engine, to operate the inlet and exhaust valve, we are using CAM and follower. In this diagram also you can observe that in an IC engine chamber you have to put some, or you have to give some input of either gas or gas and fuel mixture. In that case you have to open and close the valve at particular time. Also you have to open and close an exhaust valve where the exhaust gases you have to take out. So the valve timing of this inlet and outlet valve must be precise, and that will be done with the help of CAM and follower. So how it is doing, that we will see further next. Second, many examples are there, such as automatic attachment of machineries, paper cutting machines, spinning and weaving textile machineries, feed mechanism of automatic lathes. In these all examples we are using CAM and follower. Now what is the classification of these followers? We will see first classification of follower, then we will see classification of CAMs. So the followers are broadly classified into three main categories, such as according to the surface contact, secondly according to the motion of follower, and thirdly according to the path of motion of follower. So one thing remember to tell you that I forgot to tell you that the CAM and follower have the line contact between these two. That's why they are called as a higher pairs. You know what is a higher pair and what is lower pair. Whenever the contact between the two links is line contact or point contact, they are called as a higher pairs, and if the contact between the two links is surface contact, they are called as a lower pairs. So here CAM and follower is the example of a higher pair, remember this. And the CAM is usually rotating about the uniform speed of the shaft, but the follower motion is predetermined, and it will be according to the shape of the CAM. As the shape of the CAM changes, the motion of the follower will also change. So these things must be remembered. Now according to classification, we will see according to the surface contact, there are four types. This classification we will see in detail in next slides, but just for information I have put all this classification on the same slide. Just I will read out the names. According to the surface contact, there are four types of followers, that is knife edge follower, roller follower, flat faced or mushroom follower, and last is a spherical faced follower. Secondly, according to the motion of follower, two types are there, that is the reciprocating or oscillating follower. Third, according to the path of motion, followers are divided into two types, that is a radial follower and offset follower. We will see these all one by one. First, according to surface contact, first type is knife edge follower. Now what is knife edge follower? When the contacting end of the follower has the sharp knife edge, it is called as a knife edge follower. You can observe in that animation and diagram also, the contacting element or contacting end of the follower is having sharp knife edge, and there is point contact between this sharp knife edge and cam, and the sliding motion takes place between these contacting surfaces. And what are the contacting surfaces? Here contacting surfaces are the knife edge and cam surface, and there is a sliding motion between these two. As there is sliding motion, there will be larger amount of excessive amount of wear will be there. So in therefore these are less used, knife edge followers are less used in actual application because there is a larger amount of wear and tear of that knife edge. Also in knife edge follower, the considerable side thrust is also existing between the follower and guides. That's why they are also less used. Now we will move to the second type, that is a roller follower. So previously we have seen first type, that is a knife edge follower, and there is a sliding contact between the knife edge and cam. In second type, there is a rolling motion between the follower and cam. Now what is roller follower? When the contacting end of the follower is a roller, it is called as a rolling follower, and there is a sliding motion between the two contacting surfaces, that is roller and cam. As there is a rolling motion, therefore the rate of wear is generally less. In roller follower, there is also a side thrust exists between these two, that is follower and guide. Therefore these are also less used. The roller follower are extensively or generally used where the space is available more. In applications such as a stationary gas or oil engine and aircraft engine, we are using these rolling followers. Next, we will move to next, that is third type, that is a flat faced or mushroom follower. When the contacting end of the follower is perfectly flat face, you can observe here the contacting end of the follower is exactly flat face, therefore it is called as a flat faced follower. It may be noted that the side thrust between the follower and guide is much reduced in this case. That's why they are used many times. The only side thrust is due to the friction between the contacting surface and follower of the cam. And the relative motion between these surfaces is sliding in nature. That's why wear may be reduced. That's why there is a sliding contact. That's why there is small amount of wear. And that small amount of wear we can reduce by offsetting the axis of follower. So how to offset that axis of follower, that we will see further. But this is one of the method to reduce the wear between these two contacting elements to offset the follower. Now this can be done here to reduce the offset. To reduce the wear. Now next point regarding this is the flat faced followers are generally used where the space is limited, such as the cams which operate on the walls of the automobile engine. There you can use this kind of flat faced followers. Now here also one more name I have written there, that is a mushroom follower. This is because when the flat faced follower is a circular in nature, then it is called as a mushroom follower. In animation you can observe that these ends of that flat faced follower are circular. That's why they are called as a mushroom followers. Understand? Now next type, fourth type, we will see, that is a spherical faced follower. When the contacting end of the follower is a spherical in shape, it is called as a spherical faced follower. Now it may be noted that when the flat faced follower is used in automobile engine, the high surface stresses are produced, that we have seen in last point. Now in order to minimize these stresses, the flat end of the follower is machined to the spherical shape as shown in these diagrams. In these two diagrams, you can observe in first diagram, you can observe the end is, that flat end is little bit spherical. That's why these are called as a spherical faced followers. And the motion of that follower is reciprocating, that is up and down. And in second diagram, you can observe that There is also a follower which has a spherical faced follower, and it will move up and down, but it is hinged at one point. That's why it can move in it. Its motion is called as oscillating motion. So both motions I have shown here. First motion is reciprocating motion, and second motion is an oscillating motion about one point. So this is a spherical faced follower. Now these are the four types according to surface contact. First type according to surface contact we have seen, that is a cam and knife edge follower. Second, cam with a rolling follower. Third, cam with a flat face follower. And last, that is a cam with a spherical faced follower. Now second classification we will see, that is according to the motion of follower. According to the motion of follower, these are divided into two types. From that, first one is reciprocating or translating follower. When the follower reciprocates in the guides, as ram rotates uniformly, it is known as a reciprocating or translating followers. You can observe in all these types, previously whatever four types we have seen, in all these four types, the follower is oscillating, or follower is moving up and down, or there is motion, linear motion. It is exactly parallel or exactly coinciding to the axis of shaft. You can observe that it is exactly passing through the axis of shaft, and the follower is reciprocating continuously up and down about the guide. This is first type, that is a translating follower or reciprocating follower. And second type is oscillating follower. When the uniform rotary motion of the cam is observed into the predetermined oscillatory motion of the follower. Whenever cam is rotating, it transmits the motion, oscillatory motion into follower. In this type, second type, it transmits the motion into follower. That motion is oscillatory motion. That's why it is called as a oscillating or rotating follower. The follower I shown in this diagram is an oscillating follower. The oscillating follower is oscillating about that fulcrum point. That's why it is called as oscillating or rotating follower. Now third type of classification, that is according to the path of motion of follower. There are also two types according to path of motion of follower. What path the follower follows, according to that, these two types are there. That is radial follower, first type. When the motion of the follower is along the axis passing through the center of cam, it is called as a radial follower. In all these diagrams, you can observe that the path which followed by the follower is reciprocating or oscillating. It is having an axis passing through exactly center of cam. That's why it is called as a radial follower. In second type, that is a offset follower, here you can observe that there is one axis passing through the follower which is certain have offset from the axis of cam. Therefore, when the motion of follower is along the axis away from the axis of cam center, it is called as offset follower. Here we have seen that there are two types of follower according to the path of motion of the follower, that is a radial follower and offset follower. Now in all these cases, follower must be constrained to follow the cam or profile of the cam. This may be done by the springs or gravity or hydraulic means. In some types, the cams and follower may be ride in the groove also. That we will see next while looking to the classification of cams. So next we will see the classification of cams. Though the cams are classified in many ways, yet we will see only important types of cams as per our syllabus is concerned. So the first type is radial or disc cam. So in radial cams, the follower reciprocates or oscillates in the direction perpendicular to cam's axis. And the cam is, whatever I had shown in all the figures, have the motions which is exactly perpendicular to the cam axis. You can observe here axis of cam and the axis of follower. So axis of follower is exactly perpendicular to axis of cam, whereas second type is there, that is a cylindrical cams. In that cylindrical cams, the follower reciprocates or oscillates in the direction parallel to the cam axis. You can observe here in first diagram, whenever the cylindrical cam rotates about its own axis, then the follower follows the groove over the cam, and when the groove is followed by the follower, that follower will reciprocate horizontally, exactly parallel to the cam axis. And in second diagram also you can observe that whenever cam is rotated, then the follower follows the groove over the cam, and that motion of the follower will be nearly oscillating about one fulcrum point, but it is also nearly parallel to the axis of cam. That's why these are the two classification of cam. First type is a radial cam and second type is a cylindrical cam. Whatever radial cams are there, these are the important as per our syllabus point of view as compared to cylindrical cams. That's why we will focus more on this radial cams in the next further videos. So thanks for watching, and if you are liking these videos, so subscribe to this channel Shri Tech Education and stay tuned to get the further videos. Thank you all.